Hi everyone, this is Dr. A again. So for our second video in our introduction to the clinical lab setting, we're going to look at who works in the clinical laboratory. So first we have medical technologists, also referred to as MTs or MLS, also known as clinical laboratory scientists. So depending where you're at, it's going to determine what they're called. This person has a Bachelor of Science in Clinical Laboratory Science from a NACLS accredited program. They can get a national certification through the AACP Board of Registry. And their job is to perform lab tests, to supervise, teach, and troubleshoot instrument as needed. They can become a lab supervisor or a lab director with this bachelor's degree. Although I will say that often in larger hospitals, they do want their lab directors to get a master's degree. But anyway, at least with a bachelor's of science in clinical lab science, the pathway to lab director is pretty wide open. Next, you have the medical lab technician, or an MLT. They're also known as a clinical laboratory technician. They have an associate's degree, so an AAS in clinical lab sciences from a NACLS accredited institution or program. They can also get a national certification through the AACP Board of Registry. They perform the lab tests and they can assist in the collection of lab specimens. They are more an on-the-bench worker, although they can rise up to some supervisory positions. It just really kind of depends. They usually prefer the bachelor's level techs to go into supervisory and lab director positions, but I have known some lab directors to be MLTs, so it is entirely possible. Then we have lab assistants. They're also known as clinical laboratory assistants. They may have an associate's of science or a certificate in a VOTEC program, but not a NACLS accredited clinical lab technician program. So this is a different level. So there's no national certification through the AACP Board of Registry for lab assistants. They generally just collect and or process some lab specimens, and they can perform some basic lab tests on blood and urine. These are the type of tests that are what we call wave tests that can also be done by the nursing staff. So they can do things like run a pregnancy test or do some of the quick tests that are very easy to perform, and so they can help with the workflow in the lab. Then we have our phlebotomist. They may have a certificate of completion from a vocational or technical school, but actually all you need to be a phlebotomist is a high school diploma and some training. And because there's a shortage of phlebotomists, there's a lot of employers that will do on-the-job training for phlebotomy with somebody that just has interest in a high school diploma. You can get a national certification through the AACP Board of Registry in phlebotomy. And a phlebotomist will collect and possibly also process specimens. And the phlebotomist is considered the face of the lab because they have the most patient interaction. And so we very much value our phlebotomy team. So the hierarchy of the clinical lab staff from highest authority to the lowest. So the top dog here is the medical director, and they are over the pathologist, clinical biologist, microbiologist, or biochemist. Next would be, if there is one, a resident in pathology or clinical biology. And then they are over the pathology assistant, microbiologist assistant, or medical biochemist assistant. And so these, the PAs, the pathologist assistants, are more like a master's level trained people, whereas your residents have completed some of their doctorate, but not their residency, whereas their medical director and the pathologist are MDs. They have a medical degree. And they have finished their rotations, their residencies. And then next you have the lab manager. The lab manager is really who does the day-to-day managing and running of the lab. So the lab manager has chief techs or department supervisors that report to them. This breakdown kind of depends on the lab. So there's lead techs and department supervisors. Sometimes those are used interchangeably. If the lab is big enough, then they may actually be a department supervisor, and then also underneath the department supervisor, some lead techs. It just really depends on the size of the lab. And then next are your medical technologists, your clinical lab scientists, your cytotechnologists and histotechnologists. So these are the people that have bachelor's level training. Next is going to be the medical laboratory technician or clinical lab technician. So these guys have an associate's level training. And then underneath them are the lab assistants or clinical lab assistants, who usually just only have a certificate or some other training and have just been trained to come and help process specimens and help in the lab. And underneath the lab assistant, you have the phlebotomist. Again, does all the collection of the samples. And then underneath those, if you have a lab big enough, you may have a transcriptionist and or a secretary. And so they can help with transcribing, obviously, all of the reports from the pathologist, and the secretaries can do a lot of the kind of day-to-day activities and answering the phone, etc. Although in a lot of labs that I've worked in, the phlebotomist ends up doing a lot of secretary work too. So there you go. That is a hierarchy of the lab and who all works in the lab.